An Oahu resident called Action Line for help after the tsunami scare 2 weeks ago. The scare forced the cancellation of the Ko'olina Triathlon, leaving athletes with no race and no refund. Tyzo Braden has more in tonight's Action Line report.
Damon Ia loves to race.
I really love that race, you know. That's my favorite race out of all the triathlons.
So with all the training, Damon and many of his friends were crushed when they found out that the tsunami scare had forced the cancellation of the Ko'olina Triathlon with no refund. A similar situation happened in New York City after race officials canceled the NYC Marathon due to the destruction caused by Hurricane Sandy. Again, with no refund. In both cases, race organizers pointed out the no refund policy that was stated on the websites well before the race start.
But the thing was, it never said specifically that no refund in the case of a natural disaster. What they said about the natural disaster on the application is they have the right to reschedule the event, but nothing about a refund. So that's my question.
And when it comes to putting on large events, well-known promoter Tom Moffitt knows the danger weather possesses, especially when putting on musical concerts.
Any events that are held in Honolulu at the Stan Share Center, the Blaisdell, the Waikiki Shell, or Aloha Stadium, when they buy a ticket, the money they pay for the ticket is held in escrow. So if there is some kind of a cancellation, they will get their money back.
But there are different rules for sporting events. Ko'olina race organizer J.J. Johnson declined to comment on air, but he did mention the expenses and non-refundable costs that he incurred planning the year's event, and that all of this year's athletes will get a 50% off on next year's race. But for Damon, that's not enough, especially with all the training spent for the race.
So the third best thing would just be to give us an entry fee for next year. But, you know, giving us only 50% entry fee next year, it's kind of a slap in the face.
Tyzo Braden, KHON 2 News, Hawaii's news leader.
If you have a consumer concern, call our Action Line volunteers weekdays from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. at 591-0222. You can also email Action Line at khon2.com.